Hello everyone, it's Dominic again, and this morning I still want to encourage you following the last video that I made concerning confession of sins. When we repent, when we regret, when we come to the point of acknowledging that we have sinned against God, or when we want to walk with God, we confess our sins. We publicly declare the things we have done. The Bible says in Matthew chapter 3 from verse 5, it says that then went out to him Jerusalem and all Judea and all the region round about Jordan, and were baptized of him in Jordan, confessing their sins. When people went to be baptized by John the Baptist, they confessed their sins. My friends, there is no repentance without confession of sins. There is no turning around without telling God, without listening to God, what you have done. Enumerating, Lord, I have stolen. Lord, I have been a liar. Lord, I have been an adulterer. Lord, when you confess your sins, you become free from those sins. You put the devil to an open shame. Many people, many of you have turned from your sin. No, you've not turned from your sin. Many of you have decided to follow God, but leaving your sins, not wanting to confess the sins because you are ashamed of them. You don't know that by confessing those sins, that's how you will liberate yourself from that demon that is always coming behind you over and over and over. And because you are hiding him, you are hiding him and keeping him, that's why you are not being able to be delivered completely from that evil you are doing. You need to expose that devil by confessing it openly. So this confession of sin is actually part of a repentance process. It's actually part of a coming back process. I give you again another scripture in Leviticus chapter 5 verse 5. I will read from here. It says, so it shall be when a person is guilty in one of these that he shall confess the sin he has committed. You will confess the sin you have committed in Leviticus 5 verse 5. You will confess that sin. You will not say that, Lord, I know that I am a bad person. Lord, I know that I am a sinner. No. That is not how you confess your sins, man. You are hiding something. To confess your sins, you must call them by their name. Like that, you will be free. You will be free. Take it very seriously. Are you struggling to walk with Jesus? You must open your heart. Take for example someone who is sick and goes to the hospital, and the doctor has to examine you. What do you do? At times the doctor asks you to pull off your clothes, and many of you will do that without any complaining. You pull off your clothes in front of a stranger, but just because he is a doctor and is going to give you the solution, you pull off your clothes. How about exposing your heart to Jesus? How about opening your heart to Jesus? The Bible says, confess your sins one to another. Pray one for another, for the effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. Have you hurt somebody? Have you stolen something from somebody? This pushes me to read about Zacchaeus. Zacchaeus in Luke chapter 19 verse 8 to 9. Luke chapter 19 verse 8 to 9. I'm reading here in my laptop. It says, but Zacchaeus stood up and said to the Lord, look, Lord, here and now I give half of my possession to the poor. And if I have cheated anybody of anything, I will pay back four times. Pay back. Underline that. What I am stressing here is confession of sins. And I show you here how Zacchaeus is telling Jesus that he will pay back, restitute, give back. When you confess your sins, if you hurt people, you've stolen people's money, you've been corrupt, you took someone's wife, you took someone's husband, you know what you ought to do? Restore. I will give back. Have you given back the things you took, the things you stole? Maybe your house is constructed by stolen money. You bought your car with stolen money, with corrupt money. You build your house, you bought your land with such money. Have you restored, or you call yourself a child of God? Think about it. The Bible says it. When we repent, we confess our sins. I think in my previous video, I spoke about it already. People who were baptized by John, they were confessing their sins. In the book of Acts, people who believe came and confessed their sins openly and showed their works, and they brought even their magical books, things that were abominable things, and they burned them all, and they say, "We are free today." Have you confessed your sins, or you are still keeping them? Surrender all to Jesus involves confessing and exposing the devil that is in your life by speaking it out. Don't say, "Oh, many of you say many a time somebody preaches the gospel to you and say that, okay, I'm going to lead you in a prayer, in a sinner's prayer. Lord, from today, I am turning from my sins," and you are putting your hand up like somebody that they have surrendered and they want to steal from him, and you are putting your hand up and say, "Lord, from today," well, you know, from the part of the world where I'm coming from, in the big towns, if you see somebody standing like this, then you know what is going to happen. Maybe they are putting a gun on his head and they want to take out money from his pocket. You are not such. The Bible didn't say that you just say only a sinner's prayer and that will be okay. No, you have to confess your sins. When you come to yourself, yes, the preacher is leading you in a sinner's prayer. What do you say? What do you say? When you come back to yourself, you must confess your sins. The Bible talk about the prodigal son who came back. The Bible says when he came back to himself, he said, "I will go back to my father and I will tell my father this." He said, "I will tell my father that I have sinned against heaven and I've sinned against you." That's what he said. And he effectively told his father what he did. "I have sinned against you." You need to confess your faults. That's how you go. If you want to succeed, if you want to live a life free from sin, you must confess your sins and declare what you've done. Like that, you'll be free, and you tell the devil, "I am no longer with you." That's how it works. In Psalms 51, after David had committed adultery and killed someone, here is his confession in Psalms 51. I'm reading from verse 14. He says that, "Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God." Some of you will never call your sin by name because you know you want to keep doing it. You wait when in your churches, prayers is always done together. And when everybody is praying, you just chip in inside, "Oh God, forgive me for what?" You are deceiving yourself. You ought to confess your sins. Why should people not hear you confessing your sin when confession means an open declaration? Confession means going to meet someone and telling the person that, "I hated you. I have been jealous of you. I have been envying you. Brother, I'm sorry. Sister, please forgive me." Confession means telling your wife that, "I've been cheating on you. I have cheated on you so many times. Forgive me." That's confession. Not to just turn around. It's not to just turn around and start doing good works. It's not, doesn't work like that. In Psalms, it is still David says in the same Psalms 51, "For thou desirest not sacrifice, else I would give it. Thou delightest not in burnt offering. The sacrifice of God are a broken spirit, a broken and a contrite heart, O God, thou will not despise." God does not want sacrifice. When you sin, you ought to confess. You ought to do what the Bible says. You don't have to cover your sins with sacrifices. You cover your sins with money. When you do evil, you do wrong, instead of even saying sorry, instead for you to say sorry and to turn around for the things you have done, you struggle to make sacrifices in order to cover the evil you have done. No, my friend. No, friends. You have to confess your sins. That's what the Bible says. Don't live your own righteousness. The righteousness that the Bible approves is the righteousness of God. You don't do that. God prefers you doing what is right than covering your sin with sacrifices, carrying money to your church, carrying your tithe to your church, doing good to your pastor. After you have committed adultery, after you have stolen money from the office, you go and give part of it in the church. When your heart is condemning you, when your heart is judging you, you take part of it and you rush to church and you think that you can bribe God. You ought to restore that money and confess your sins openly. That's what the Bible says. In Psalms, I'll read another Psalms again. In Psalms 32, David describes the blessedness of the man whose sins are forgiven. He says, blessed is the one whose transgression are forgiven, whose sins are covered. Blessed is the one whose sins the Lord does not count against him. And verse 3 of Psalms chapter 32 is very important. It says that when I kept silent, listen to it very well, when I did not confess my sin, that's what it means. When I kept silent, my bones wasted through my groaning all day, for day and night your hand was heavy on me. You know very well that when you have committed sin and you do not confess that sin, it is chopping you inside. It is chopping you inside. Confession is the way of being free, friends. You need to confess and stop it. It says that when I kept silent, when I was resisting, I closed my heart, I closed it, it wasn't well with me. I encourage you, friends, confess your sins, open your heart to God. That's how you turn from sin and walk in the light. In Proverbs 28 verse 13, get it again, Proverbs 28:13. What does it say? Whosoever conceal their sin does not prosper. Whoever conceal their sin does not prosper. But the one who confesses and renounces them finds mercy. You cover your sins, there is no way for you. I am speaking to those who want to follow Jesus, those who want to turn from their sin, or those who are even following Jesus. Have you committed sin? The Bible says all have sinned. All have sinned. I'm not trying to say that there are some people who sin and there are some people who do not sin. All have sinned. And how do we come to Jesus? When we come to Jesus, we must confess, we must restitute, we must give back. We must tell people what we've done wrong. We must ask for forgiveness because we have started living the life of the light. We are walking in the light. The Bible says you are the light of the world. You are the salt of the earth. But I am emphasizing one particular important part of your turning around. One particular important part of repentance is confession of sins. Many people do not confess their sins and they keep these sins in their heart. Those demons, those wicked spirits that were stopping you from pleasing God, they will remain there and they will be haunting you all the time. Haunting you all the time. Confess your sins. Open your heart. Of course, if you are sincere, if you really, really want to change, you will do that. Only those who are hypocrites, those who don't understand what they are doing, who hide their sin. For those whose heart has been touched, whose hearts have been touched by this word, by the word of God, you will not resist God, friend. You will not resist God. You will confess your sins. You will open your heart. You will lift up your hands. You will fall on your knees. You will bring it out because you want to be free, just like that patient that will be in front of the doctor, and you will remove your clothes because you have some pain in there and you want the doctor to see it. You will pull off your clothes without any shame and you will expose yourself. So do same when you come to Jesus. Do same. Confess your faults. Dear friends, may God bless you as you meditate in this word and look through those verses that I have cited and see that the Bible really, really says that we must confess our sins, expose our sins. If this video has blessed you and if you are happy about it, why don't you share it? Share it to someone. Subscribe on my YouTube channel and subscribe even on our Facebook page. I always share at least one message every week, at least one message every week. And this is very helpful. It might not be helpful to some of you who are listening to it, but to someone else that you know, you can just share the video. God bless you, my friend, and have a wonderful week.